When Mary woke up that Sunday morning after the Sabbath, after Jesus had been killed, she was determined to be useful. Jesus was her teacher, her Lord, her friend. And now he was gone. I imagine her eyes must have been red and swollen. I'm sure there was a knot in the pit of her stomach. But she wasn't going to stay curled up in a ball any longer. She was going to go and anoint Jesus' body with the oils they hadn't been able to at his burial because of the Sabbath. I wonder, did Mary feel the gentle breeze on her face as she walked that morning? Did she hear the birds singing? I wonder, do you think that she noticed anyone at all who she passed as she walked on her path? Or was she so focused, so wrapped up in what could have been, in her grief, in the tomb waiting for her? And when she arrived, something was wrong. The stone, she hadn't even thought about how she would have the stone move so she could get in to anoint Jesus' body, but the stone was moved. She peered in to see if anyone else had had the same idea that she had had, but no one was there. And Jesus' body was gone. Grief just rushed over her all over again, and that hole in the tomb felt like a hole in her heart. So she rushed to the other disciples with a shred of hope that maybe they had an explanation. Maybe they knew something that she didn't. Maybe they could somehow make it right. But the men were just as perplexed as Mary was. Maybe Mary was confused. Maybe Mary had gone to the wrong tomb. Maybe. 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 I wonder if the three of them felt the breeze, the wind, the spirit blowing on their faces as they ran that morning. I wonder if their ears were open to hear God's victory song sung by the birds. Do you think their eyes were opened to notice anyone at all who they passed on their path? When Peter and John looked inside the tomb, they saw that everything Mary described was exactly as she had described it. Jesus' body was gone. And whoever had taken it had left the linens, but taking the time to roll some of them up nice and neat. Why? Why? They left without any answers, just more questions. and that helpless feeling when nothing can be done. But Mary stayed. She just couldn't move. And when she peered in the tomb again, there were two angels who, maybe for one of the only times in all of Scripture, did not tell her that she didn't need to be afraid. They needn't be concerned because Mary wasn't fazed. She didn't wonder that there was anyone in the tomb. She didn't wonder that there were angels dressed in white. And she didn't wonder at where they had been just moments earlier when Peter and John had been there. Mary was just focused. She wanted to know where Jesus was. Nothing else mattered. And then Mary turned, and there was a man standing there. He seemed familiar. Wasn't he there earlier that morning when she had first gone to the tomb?
No.
Hadn't Peter and John and Mary run past him time and time again? Wasn't he there just the whole time? The gardener, as Mary supposed. Maybe he could help. And when he asked her whom she was looking for, not what, but whom, Mary couldn't seem to even look at his face. And then Jesus said Mary's name. And the whole world changed. Suddenly, darkness became light. Grief turned to joy. All that had been broken was made whole and renewed. Now Mary could feel the breeze. She could hear the birds, and she could see. Her eyes were open. Jesus was there, face to face, standing right in front of her, plain as day. You see, earlier that morning, Mary and Peter and John had just been submerged in their grief. Their eyes were swollen shut. They couldn't see. They missed the angels. They didn't notice them. They paid no attention to the gardener, and they just did not see at all the miracles right there before them, because they were busy looking for a lifeless body. They were looking for the wrong thing. There was no lifeless body there. There was only life. That's how Jesus is. Alive. Say it with me. Jesus is alive.
Jesus is alive.
And full of surprises, and we never know where or when or how he's going to show up. Maybe we rushed right past him this morning. Or how many times might we have rushed past him this week, this month? How often have we suppose someone to be just a gardener or just anyone, when if we had stopped and opened our eyes and paid attention, we might see Jesus face to face. Sometimes I think we're just so busy. We get focused on how we think things ought to be, or what could have been. We get wrapped up in ourselves, our time, our possessions, that maybe we don't always hear when Jesus says our name. I assure you that during those times when we feel lost and alone, when we can't seem to find purpose, when we are trapped in regret, when we fear that nothing about what we do or who we are is good enough or worthy to be loved, when hope seems lost, when we fear what will come after our last breath, Christ is right there with us, calling us by name, calling us by name out of our empty tomb so that he can show us that death has been defeated, love has won. That gardener, who maybe we didn't notice, offers us unconditional love and grace no matter what. He offers us hope and healing and wholeness, even if we haven't been paying attention. Wherever we are. Because Christ is with us always. Always. That's what Easter's about. He hasn't left us. He will never leave us. And so this Easter, may all of our eyes be open, so we can see the miracles right before us. So we can look around and announce to one another with confidence that the resurrection is true. We have seen the Lord. Amen. Amen. Amen.